No extension? No problem. That'll identify almost any file type. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question: I downloaded a few video files without extensions. I tried inserting all of the common extensions, but none of them would play. Is there a way to determine which format the files are in? Well, for video files, my gut answer is to say I don't know. Video files and their formats are, well, a complex maze of twisty passages all alike. But we can get a few clues, not only about your video files, but about other file types as well. Many, though certainly not all, files begin with a series of fixed values that identify the type of file that they are. This is referred to as a file's signature, or sometimes its magic number. A great example is the .exe file. All .exe files begin with two bytes, 4D and 5A. That's the hexadecimal, or just hex, value for the uppercase letters M and Z, which, as it turns out, are the initials of the Microsoft engineer who defined that original file format. If the first two bytes of a file are M and Z, then you're looking at a .exe file or one of its derivatives, like a .dll file. So the approach to identifying is to examine the first few bytes of a file and then use what we find there to see if we can determine the file format. Now, the MZ example happens to use printable characters. And indeed, if you open a .exe file in Notepad, I don't really recommend, but you can, you'll see MZ at the very beginning. But signatures aren't always printable characters. That means we need to look at the contents of the file in hexadecimal. The tool that I use is the freeware HXD. There'll be a link to the tool in the companion article that goes along with this video, linked in the description. Caution: HXD is a hex editor, meaning that besides looking at what the file has, you can modify files with it. So be careful not to accidentally make changes. You could corrupt files, or your system, or your hard drive by modifying the wrong things. Fortunately, HXD makes it obvious that you're changing things by displaying changes in red, and it includes proper confirmations and backup files by default. I have open here on the screen HXD. We'll go File and Open, and let's see, what shall we look at? How about this random program that I have no idea what it is, but it's a .exe file, so we'll do that. And sure enough, if we take a look at the very first two bytes here, you'll see that they are 4D and 5A, or the letters M and Z, exactly as we expected. If I open a different file, I'm not sure what we'll find here. There's a .dll, same thing. It starts with 4D and 5A, just like a .exe file. Okay, we'll continue on. We'll look at something else. We'll File, Open. This time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at some files on my hard drive in my documents. There's a PDF file. Let's see what they start with. And there it is, %PDF-1. You can see that sometimes these signatures are pretty obvious. PDF files are really obvious about what they are. Others aren't. Let's find one where we're not sure. I'm going to go ahead and open up another file that I've created here on my system called example.foo. No idea what this file is. We'll open it, and we can see that it starts with the 3F and 5F. In other words, in this case, you can see over here, that's a question mark and an underscore character. What could that possibly mean? Now, there's really no definitive list of file signatures, but the Wikipedia list of file signatures is actually pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that up. It turns out I already have it here in my browser. And I'm just going to search the page for 3F. And the first thing it shows is exactly what we found, 3F, 5F. Question mark underscore. That means it's a Windows 3x9598 help file. In other words, it's from the old WinHelp utility. And I can confirm that this is correct because I was on that team. 3F and 5F represent the question mark and underscore, and that's not a coincidence. It's actually a really bad character representation of the original WinHelp program's icon, a question mark and a little shadow behind it. I do have to caution you that, yes, this is super geeky, and if it's not geeky enough, be careful when you're scanning the table of signatures for matches. Make sure that what you have matches what you see. If there is more than one possibility, and there sometimes is, choose the longest candidate that matches. And the file format you need may not even be there. Again, I have not found an exhaustive list. The file format you need might be ambiguous. Several signatures list more than one application. Perhaps any additional knowledge you have of where the file came from will help distinguish among all the possibilities. And finally, of course, knowing the file format may not be enough. AVI files are a great example because they're container files that can contain audio and video in many different encodings. Of course, most of this is idle and even historical curiosity. However, if you come across a file that you're trying to identify, you're now armed with some additional information. Hopefully, you'll be able to gather some additional clues about exactly what kind of file it is you have. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/183497. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.